Hello everyone, welcome to yet another video tutorial of WebEpic channel. In today's video, we'll be talking about how to add currency code or currency symbol to product price. In the same video, we'll be also learning how to use prefix and suffix into feed configuration. And obviously, we'll be using CTX feed as usual. So without further ado, let's get along with the video. So I'm at my WordPress website right now. Let's go to CTX feed. That's the plugin we'll be using today. Let's go to test feed. I'm using Google Shopping as my templates, and in the feed configuration, you'll see there is a category named Google attributes, and there are sell price and there is also regular price. It's a preset of Google Shopping template. So now I'll show you how to set prefix and suffix and also currency code and currency symbol. So obviously you don't want your price without an unit. So let's add a currency here. Let's go with US dollar. So I'm typing as my suffix USD. And here in the sell price also I'm putting USD. You can put any currency at your will, but I'm just putting US dollar here. I'm also using the dollar sign as my prefix. Let's do something else. Let's just edit my prefix and suffix in the product title. Let's just write new, and there should be the product title after that, and which is in stock. So let's just put in stock as my suffix, and let's just update and generate feed and see what happens in the XML file. So right now I'm in the XML file. Let's search with price. So you can see there is as I put the dollar sign as prefix and USD as suffix, it's showing dollar sign before the digit 150 and after it's showing USD. That means the prefix and suffix is working here before and after the amount that I've put for this particular product, and it's working all over this XML file. And let's see what happened to my product title. I put new as my prefix and in stock at my suffix. Let's just search for new here. Okay, so as you can see, my product was stove and it's adding new stove in as my prefix and in stock as a suffix. But the problem is there is no space here. There should be a space between new and stove, and also in stock there is no space, like new soap in stock, but there is no space in between new soap and in. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna edit my prefix and I put a space after new, and as my suffix I'm putting a space before in stock. And now let's just generate my feed. It should sort out now. If I go to the XML file and now see that there is a space in between new stove and there is a space in between barbecue and in stock, and it's working all over this XML file. New soap in stock, new caps in stock. That's how you can use prefix and suffix properly. So that's how you get to add your currency code and currency symbol to product price. And now you also know how to use the prefix and suffix into feed configuration. That's all for today's video. Thank you for watching.